Tonight and for the next 12 nights, I'm the guest of Sir Arthur Streeb-Greebling, a man who needs no introduction from me, and so, without further ado, Sir Arthur, good evening.
Good evening, and season's greeblings.
Streeb-Greebling, Sir Arthur, that's a very unusual name.
Yes, the Streebs originally hailed from Iceland, or Norway as it was then, in what is now modern Denmark. Streeb is in fact a corruption of the original Norsk name, Strub.
Does that have any meaning in Norsk, in fact?
It means Strub in Norsk. It's almost impossible to translate, really. It basically means a sort of wooden bucket with two holes in it. Underwear, really, wooden underwear, which is the only sensible way to deal with the cold Norsk summer. You just take off your underwear, set it on fire, and huddle round it for warmth.
Do you speak any Lap yourself?
I have a smattering, or a smittering, as they call it. They don't in fact call it Lap, they call it Lip. Yes, but I do have a smittering of Lip. A few words, Strub, Stub, Lip. I imagine if I were to find myself in 4th century Lapland, I could get by, probably.
These Streebs then presumably migrated, did they, in their...
Long, proud underwear, yes. They migrated to Britain, which is where they first encountered the Greeblings. Now, the Greeblings were Picts, and they were quite unlike the Streebs. You see, whereas the Streebs were tall, blonde, willowy people, the Greeblings were short, dark, shrub-like folk who worshipped the ladder.
Why was that?
Well, because they'd never actually seen one, so they couldn't prove it existed, and naturally they believed in it.
Ah,
a question of faith, really. Various animals are sacred as well, the giraffe, for example. Well, legend had it that were a Pict to kill a giraffe, his family would be cursed for all eternity.
How did the Picts know about the giraffe?
Well, they only knew the theoretical giraffe, which they revered, because it didn't need a ladder. It wasn't actually a giraffe, of course. Cave paintings show a cylindrical, sausage-like animal, brownish in color, with one cylindrical leg and a 200-foot-long neck, ending in another leg. Or neck, it could be. It's not very well drawn. In fact, I think it might well be upside down, the one I saw.
I see.
They called it the 200-foot-long dog.
What would that be in Norsk?
Well, it wouldn't be in Norsk. These were Greeblings, remember. Not Streebs or Strubs.
Oh, yes, of course.
But if it was in Norsk, it would probably be something like the 200-foot-long dog.
Oh, yes. Now, you say cave paintings.
Yes, they lived in subterranean caves. Caves from which they kept up their underground resistance movement.
Against the Romans?
Yes.
Was it effective?
Oh, very effective. The Romans never got to the bottom of it. In fact, I don't think the Romans were aware of how much resistance was going on underground, since the Greeblings never surfaced, and the Romans went back to Rome in 410 AD. None the wiser.
What's your first gift, Sir Arthur?
My first gift is a partridge in a pear tree.
Why that?
For two reasons.
What's the first reason?
Would you mind if I did my second reason first?
Of course.
My second reason is that I'm an enormous admirer of Marlon Brando.
What's the connection?
Well, Marlon has a habit of dressing up as a partridge to avoid being bothered in restaurants. He'd go out to eat with his buddies, Walter Pigeon, Howard Hawks, Gregory Peck, the usual crowd, and this is coming back to my first reason, in the Pear Tree.
Yes.
Which, of course, was an exclusive restaurant in the Hollywood Hills, where you could only get in if you were disguised as a bird, and you could only get out if you'd settled your bill, which was sort of an in-joke in Beverly Hills in those days.
Is a sense of humor important to you, Sir Arthur?
Terribly important, yes. And, of course, it is the way to a woman's heart. Soft music, a bottle of wine, candlelight, then as the meal draws to a close, slip on an albatross costume and say, "Oh, look, there's my bill." Love will blossom. Or you could point to somebody called William, I suppose. Either would work, I imagine.
Sir Arthur, you have your partridge, you have your pear tree.
Thank you.
And we look forward very much to seeing you tomorrow and finding out what your second gift is.
Thank you very much.
Not at all.
You don't mind if I smoke?
Me good.
And that's at the earlier time of 9:25.